So over the years, Attack on Titan has gone through a lot of different changes. Its world, its characters, and its atmosphere specifically have evolved, transformed. It's traversed past its kind of original intention for its atmosphere and its world building and moved on to something a little bit more appropriate for its story. For me, Attack on Titan started off very heavy. Its world was very dark and teeming with these very dangerous situations. These titans that were introduced into the story very, very early on depict fear and emotion very heavily. Titans are ridiculously powerful, evil, dangerous, and going up against them is kind of suicide. This idea is grounded into you since chapter one. Not only through the concept of characters going up against Titans and ultimately dying, but also through Eren and the people surrounding Eren, telling him that it is a suicide mission to want to join the Survey Corps. This is very impactful because the original atmosphere that Isayama kind of built from the beginning was surrounding the fear of Titans. We as readers are meant to be scared. We are so unknown to this idea of Titans. Where do they come from? Why do they exist? Why are they so powerful and strong? Why do they have the shape that they do? All of the questions that we had towards it helps build a more terrifying picture, which helps push the narrative in a more impactful way. It carries a lot more weight for Eren's decision, with him joining the Survey Corps, with him ultimately attaining the Attack Titan. Even then, the perception of Titans and the fear towards them is still there, but it shifts ever so slightly. This is kind of the first time throughout the story that we see a different perspective of Titans, with a little bit of political nature sprinkled over the top. With the way people viewed Eren, and how Eren even viewed himself at that time, turning into this monster that all of these people hated. All of these people were scared of the idea of Titans, but now our main character suddenly has the ability to turn into one. Are we meant to be scared of the main character? Are we meant to show sympathy towards him? How are we meant to feel about this whole idea, this whole situation? For me, the idea of Titans and even the portrayal of Titans is beautifully done, especially in the first kind of half of the story, if you will. The fearsome nature that they uphold, the gruesome depictions that we've seen with Titans just endlessly killing people, them being split in half and losing limbs, and just this very bloody and gruesome and realistic depiction of how hopeless humans are towards them. How much of a threat that these Titans actually uphold to everyday human nature is very, very massive. And it's woven into the story in so many different aspects, from our perspective, from Eren's perspective, from the society's perspective, from the Survey Corps perspective, even the political and government's perspective on Titans. This all happens at the beginning and slowly starts to set up things for the future. Titans won't always be feared the way they are. Humans won't be as hopeless towards them. Humans will start to thrive and overcome and overpower these said Titans. Eren was the first big step towards it, and with a bit of time with his abilities and him understanding it, there was a glimmer of hope. Even though he turned into this monstrosity of a being, which everyone was so unsure of, they slowly started to use him as a beacon, as that glimmer of hope to equal out the strength disparity between Titans and humans. Technically have a Titan on our side now, so we can potentially go toe-to-toe with these Titans just roaming around and we can fix everything. We have a powerhouse of our own. As you can see, with the power scaling starting to creep up more and more, the depiction of Titans, random Titans specifically, and the fear towards them starts to trickle away. No longer do we realistically feel scared towards Titans, and no longer do we have this hopeless feeling towards trying to attack them. We have hope now. We have a bit of power. This is a very big traversal period in introducing a brand new atmosphere for the story. If I were to kind of split up Attack on Titan in a couple of different parts, it'd be three. First would be the fear of Titans and its atmosphere towards it. The second would be a kind of interlocking of atmospheres, slowly starting to introduce new elements, starting to fizzle out the fear of Titans, and then slowly pushing everything into a political nature. And then the third part would be full-blown political. and we would fear something else entirely. The fear towards Titans and their atmosphere surrounding it, the world that is built upon it, would slowly start to lose its meaning, but its value and its impact would ultimately be there till the end of the story. The foundation that it's built is ever so strong. Like I said before, when we slowly start to power scale characters within its world, the Titans become less and less scary. Eren becomes rather frivolous with the Attack Titan ability. Him becoming pretty good at using it, ultimately adding this new layer of power towards the human society, is a very big change. Something that they've never realistically had before. Introducing Mikasa and her development becoming more powerful as a fighter. And then to kind of top it all off, we have Levi, who is kind of the god's gift of Titan slaying. Someone that can easily take out Titans, multiple Titans at a time. As you can see, the value and the fear towards Titans now has no impact. Forgetting about it, however, wouldn't be the smartest thing, because obviously Isayama knows that this is a ruthless world, and one slip up could easily put you in a situation that would get you killed. We may not be as scared of Titans as we once were back in the early days, but they are still a dangerous threat and should never be underestimated. So what is the new fear now? What is the new atmosphere for the current state of Attack on Titan? Well, that would come down to be Marley and the political nature surrounding absolutely everything. Funny enough, a lot of authors cannot pull something like this off. Having a story like Attack on Titan suddenly jump into very heavy politics and a racial warfare is very difficult to do. A lot of authors would struggle to be able to pull this off successfully, but Isayama has done an incredible job in trickling the politics over time and it becoming more fruitful and gaining a lot of impact and weight surrounding it. So when we actually dive into the racial warfare stuff, when we start to understand and learn about the history of Titans, where everything started, where everything comes from. Who is Marley? How do they feel towards Eldia? What is the history there? It's not jarring. If anything, it's very cohesively well done. It doesn't feel like it's just been implemented for the sake of introducing a political warfare arc. No, it seems like it's been there since day one, and it has been. The fear now is of humans, and it actually wraps in a pretty realistic feeling. Being scared of other humans instead of Titans now. Who is the real monster of the story? Are Titans the real monster of the story, or would it be more appropriate to say that humans are the real monster of the story? Humans that want power, humans that are greedy, humans that want to rule over different races because of a long-lasting war in history between them, because of different ideologies. If you were to start off the story like this, there would realistically be no impact there. You'd have to slowly build it up with time. But because we're jumping from the fear of Titans to the fear of Marley and the fear of humans specifically, there's a lot of realistic elements that help back it up and give it a lot of weight. A lot of people can come to understand why people are so scared of Marley. But then at the same time, you're a little bit confused because you can also understand why Marley is scared of Eldia. So even though we're having this political warfare, the idea and the ideologies between both Eldia and Marley are very similar. What makes them so different, however, is Marley's approach to the situation. Marley's approach to Eldia and kind of continuing the circle of hatred. It adds this element to the atmosphere that is actually rather scary, and that is the amount that they warp mentally, physically, and emotionally their children. They take their children and realistically turn them into child warriors. For a nation to do this successfully without any repercussions, without any thought or idea of benefiting these children in a better way, is a very detrimental thing. It's a very realistic thing in today's society, but at the same time, it's very scary because when you see these children, like Gabby, like Falco, they're so broken to the idea of hating Eldia. That's all that's ever been drilled into them. They hate Eldians, they hate the race, they hate everything that Eldia stands for. But realistically, they don't know the kind of full outstanding situation that's going on. When you think about the circle of hatred, the children of Marley continue it, and then they continue it on to the next lot of children, and they continue it on the next lot. And as you can see, it's just a repetitive cycle of manipulating the younger generation of children, the youths of this generation, to hate a specific race. Try and turn them into soldiers so they can obtain power and demolish their enemies. When you compare this side by side with Attack on Titan's story and its beginning bit, the fear of Titans and the destruction of them, wanting to kill them all, wanting to understand them to where we are now with the political nature, the child warriors, and the racial warfare with everything in between, they are completely two different atmospheres that reside within the same world. At the end of the day, Isayama has done a phenomenal job in incorporating both atmospheres that are so incredibly different, mind you, but has beautifully weaved them together to make it not jarring, not repetitive, not out of place even. He's paid a lot of attention to how his atmosphere functions, how his world functions, and how his atmosphere and his world incorporate his characters and their motives and their emotions, how they feel towards Titans, how they feel towards other people. And he's used that fear of Titans to create such a political nature that is so beautifully done with the kind of understanding of the Titan history, what Titans are specifically and where they come from. It's very impactful. And for me, Attack on Titan's world and atmosphere, alongside its artwork that incorporates it as well, is very descriptive. It's very brutal, doesn't really hold back, and it showcases the raw elements for it. And I think that's extremely important when you're dealing with fear, when you're dealing with politics, and everything in between them. Isayama has never really held back on both parts, and I think that is the reason why his atmosphere and his world is so incredibly rich, and his artwork tells it very beautifully and viciously. So with that being said, that is basically it. I've looked at Attack on Titan's first chapter. By the time this video goes up, I should have uploaded the mind of a certain character. And now I'm looking at the world and the atmosphere specifically. If you haven't noticed a pattern of my videos, this may be something new. Going back exploring chapter 1, talking about characters' minds specifically from a different perspective, and now the atmosphere of said series. If you have other series that you would like for me to talk about to this extent regarding their atmosphere alone, please let me know. I'd be interested to hear what other series you guys would like for me to talk about. But I'm actually going to end the video here. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one. Goodbye.